You probably think that growing up in a mental institution would be fun. Plenty of cigarettes and Monopoly. But it was hard at first. Gigi was pretty bummed out about her sister killing herself with laxatives, and she cried a lot. For 3 years. But with the help of good doctors and nurses at the asylum, Gigi was able to turn her sadness into anger, and we started planning our revenge. Now this is a hammer. Hammers are good for bashing people in the skull and watching them bleed to death, okay? Now how about this?
Knife.
Okay, how about this one?
Chainsaw.
Great. Now what are the advantages of using this?
Easily cuts through muscle and bone and has the added advantage of making sure your victim's final emotion is terror.
So gas.
That's great, Hester. Now let's maybe let Boone answer the next one.
But he's a moron.
I know. I know.
Ow!
We grew. Time passed. It did get a little lonely there. Sometimes I made friends, but then the next thing you know, they're getting a full frontal lobotomy. Gigi said that we would be headed to Wallace to finally put our plan into action, so I needed a persona to hide behind while we murdered people and stuff. Boone decided that his would be to pretend to be gay, which made, like, no sense, since all that would do is make him stand out amongst those frat dudes. But Boone was never one for really being smart. As for me, what I've noticed is that the more weird and gross you are, the less people want to know about you. No one asks the kid with terrible acne what their favorite movie is or where they were born. Even though I only ate asylum food and never really exercised, I was blessed with a super tight bod. My butt could launch 1,000 ships, and my boobs were remarkably perky and even. Couple that with my BJ lips, and I was gonna need something pretty spectacular to keep everyone from wanting to get all up in this. Once I saw her, I knew. I found my cloak of social invisibility. Costume. All killers have a cool costume. Jason with his hockey mask, Freddy Krueger's sweater and hat, Cujo's totally realistic doll costume.
Hey everyone, come down to Jesse Helms Stadium tonight to cheer on our very own Wallace University Red Devils! Kickoff at 7 p.m. Wow!
Kind of ironic that our first victim was actually the Red Devil, but when you want to make an omelet, right? But the devil outfit was perfect. Unisex, kind of satanic, but not like a giant goat head satanic. Red and black, so it wouldn't stain when it was covered in blood. And since it was the school mascot, we could walk around campus in it without being noticed.
I think he's dead.
It was time to begin. We broke into Kappa, and we got busy.